In this week's space news, Canadian rocket startup NordSpace ready to launch. NordSpace, a Canadian rocket launch company I've covered before on this channel, will be launching their Taiga suborbital vehicle for the first time this week. It may already have flown by the time this video is published, depending upon the weather and technical issues. NordSpace built their own launch pad in Canada and developed in-house engines and vehicle structures themselves, giving Canada sovereign launch capability. Taiga will be a stepping stone to their bigger orbital vehicle called Tundra that's currently under development. This launch will be the first commercial liquid rocket launch in Canadian history and the first commercial launch from a Canadian spaceport. With space startups taking over the business of launching payloads into space from national space agencies and governments, Canada now has its own startup, NordSpace, to give them a piece of the global commercial payload market. Canada is not new to space. The country built their first satellite in 1962, and with MDA Space, they provide the Canada arm to the International Space Station. MDA Space is also part of the Starlab consortium, aiming to build a commercial space station to replace the ISS in 2030. A Canadian astronaut will be flying on the Artemis 2 mission that will circumnavigate the moon next year. Still, NordSpace is the first entirely privately financed and managed space startup to design, build and operate a family of launch vehicles, including a future orbital vehicle. The launch takes place from NordSpace's purpose-built Atlantic Spaceport Complex launch pad. It's located outside the town of St. Lawrence in Newfoundland. This very first launch will not go that high, as the fuel load is only around 10%. It's more to test preparing and operating a launch vehicle and checking out the avionics and guidance systems. The mission duration is expected to be around 60 seconds. I've added a launch information link to the video description, which has the latest updates from NordSpace. They're hosting a live stream, so you should be able to watch the launch live. If it hasn't flown yet, I'll watch a replay from the link. The latest information from the company is the weather is favourable for a launch today. Okay, on to our second news story this week. Firefly Aerospace is cleared to launch after Alpha rocket mishap. The Federal Aviation Administration has cleared Firefly Aerospace to resume rocket launches following the failure of their Alpha rocket on the Flight 6 mission in April 2025. That mission was for their customer, Lockheed Martin, and was carrying an LM-400 technology demonstrator satellite. The flight lifted off normally, but shortly after stage separation, the first stage experienced a rupture. This generated a pressure wave that struck the second stage, causing the nozzle extension to be blown off, reducing the second stage's thrust. Lacking sufficient thrust, the second stage, along with the customer payload, failed to reach orbit, re-entering the atmosphere and ending up in the Pacific Ocean. The second stage was only 3 seconds away from achieving orbital velocity and 5 seconds short of target payload deployment orbit. It's possible that the higher than normal angle of attack on Flight 6 contributed to the anomaly. Firefly has stated that going forward, the angle of attack will be reduced during the key phases of the flight, and increased thermal protection will be added to the first stage. Hopefully, these corrective actions will prevent future missions suffering the same mishap. With FAA approval to return to flight and corrective actions implemented, Firefly is now working to determine the next available launch window for Alpha Flight 7. It's worth noting that of the 6 flights so far, only 2 have been completely successful, which is only a 33% success rate. Firefly is competing with Rocket Lab, which has an extremely high success rate. Firefly is working on a medium launch vehicle called Eclipse, in partnership with Northrop Grumman. We'll keep you informed on updates for their Alpha rocket and their upcoming larger rocket, Eclipse. Okay, on to our final story this week. Rocket Lab activates Neutron launch pad. Rocket Lab, the New Zealand and US space startup, is a global leader in launching small payloads to orbit using their Electron rocket. It's flown 70 times so far and is second only to SpaceX in the number of total rocket launches from a Western private commercial company. The company is developing a medium-lift launch vehicle called Neutron, designed to compete with SpaceX's Falcon 9 rocket. This new vehicle will operate from the Wallops complex in Virginia, where the newly constructed launch pad was officially opened this week. Launch Complex 3 is a dedicated test launch and landing facility for the reusable Neutron rocket. Although Neutron is far more reusable than the company's expendable Electron rocket, it is not entirely reusable, since the second stage is expended on each flight. However, the first stage and fairings are reusable. After the second stage deploys from the open fairings, the two fairing halves close back up as the first stage returns back to the launch site. This should reduce launch costs and allow Rocket Lab to compete directly with SpaceX's partly reusable Falcon 9 rocket. It took Rocket Lab only 2 years to build this launch pad, including the launch mount that uses 700 tons of steel and the water deluge system to reduce the sound of the launch and quench the fire from the engines at liftoff. The propellant farms hold over 180,000 gallons of liquid oxygen and liquid natural gas needed to fuel the Neutron vehicle. This facility marks the fourth launch pad owned and operated by Rocket Lab, with two located at their New Zealand site and the third, dedicated to Electron launches, situated directly next to the new one. Do you think Rocket Lab's new Neutron vehicle will be able to compete successfully with SpaceX's Falcon 9 rocket? Or is SpaceX too entrenched now, making its number one position unassailable? Leave your thoughts and opinions in the comment section below. Thanks for watching. If you enjoyed this space news video, consider buying me a coffee to help fund more episodes like this. The link is in the description. Space News Live is on Saturday evening or Sunday morning, depending where you watch from. The live stream is a great way for you to share your thoughts and opinions on the videos I posted this week, or on any space topic in general. I highlight the most thought-provoking comments on videos I've received, along with late-breaking space news and previews of upcoming content. If you've got the time, please tune in and say hi. Be sure to like and subscribe so you'll see our upcoming videos. We make videos every week covering the space industry, with an emphasis on the smaller space startups that aren't covered so well on other channels. See you soon.